Welcome to the online session conducted by Shri Ram Dandekar on behalf of Navakokand Education Society's DBJ College, Chibrun. My mobile number is 94200-50909. You can ask your doubts on this mobile number through WhatsApp. We are studying Mathematics Paper 2. In which we are studying probability distribution. We already have studied random variables, types of random variables, continuous and discrete. Then we have seen probability distribution of a random variable, discrete random variable. We have seen discrete random variable, its probability mass function. Also, we have studied the cumulative distribution function, capital Fx, and also we have studied the expected value and variance of discrete random variable probability distribution. Today, we are going to study continuous random variable, its probability density function, cumulative distribution function. Probability distribution of CRV, that is continuous random variable. We can write it CRV. A continuous random variable differs from discrete random variable in the sense that the possible values of continuous random variable form an interval of real numbers. In other words, a continuous random variable has uncountably infinite possible values. For example, the time an athlete takes to complete 1000 meter race is a continuous random variable. We shall extend what we learned about discrete random variable to a continuous random variable. More specifically, we shall study the probability distribution of continuous random variable with help of its probability density function and cumulative distribution function, CDF and PDF. The possible values of a continuous random variable x form the interval AB, where A and B are real numbers with A smaller than B. Then the closed interval AB is called the support of the continuous random variable x. The support of continuous random variable is often denoted by S. In case of discrete random variable x that takes finite or countably infinite distinct values, the probability of single element x is determined for every possible value x of the random variable capital X. The probability distribution of continuous random variable is not defined in terms of probabilities of possible values of the random variable, since the number of possible values are uncountably infinite. Instead, the probability distribution of continuous random variable is characterized by probabilities of interval of the form closed interval CD, where C is less than D. That is, for a continuous random variable, the interest is in probabilities of the form probability C less than X less than D, where A is less equal to C is less than D is less equal to B. This probability is obtained by integrating the function of capital X over the interval C to D, closed interval. Let us first define the probability density function PDF of continuous random variable. The probability density function PDF X be a continuous random variable, we can write it as CRV, defined on interval S is equal to open interval A comma B. A non-negative integrable function fx is called probability density function PDF of x if it satisfies the following conditions. The first condition is fx is positive or zero for every fx is positive or zero everywhere in S. That is, fx is greater or equal to zero for all x belonging to S. Second, the area under the curve y equal to fx over S is 1. That is, integration over the support S of the density function fx is 1. The probability that x takes value in capital A, where A is some interval, that is subset of S, is given by the integral of fx over that interval. That is, probability of x belonging to capital A is equal to integration of fx over A. Let us now define the cumulative distribution function CDF. It is just like the CDF of CDF capital FX of discrete random variable. In that discrete random variable, we were adding from beginning to that point. Here also we are adding the infinite probabilities, that is we are taking integration. The cumulative distribution function CDF of continuous random variable X is defined as capital Fx is equal to integration from A to X Ft dt for all A less than X less than B. You might recall for a discrete random variable that capital Fx is in general a non-decreasing step function. For continuous random variable, Fx is also non-decreasing continuous function. Let us see the solved problems now. The first one is, let X be a continuous random variable whose probability density function is fx is equal to 3x square for 0 less than x less than 1. Note that fx is not probability x is equal to x. For example, f of 0.9 is equal to 3 into 0.9 square, which is equal to 2.43, which is greater than 1, which is clearly not a probability, because we know that probability of any element or of any event cannot increase than 1. In the continuous case, fx is height of the curve at capital X is equal to small x, so that the total area under the curve is 1. Here it is areas under the curve that define the probabilities. Now let us start by verifying that fx is a valid probability function. For this, note the following result. First one, fx is equal to 3x square. It is greater or equal to 0 for all x between 0 and 1. Secondly, integration from 0 to 1 fx is equal to integration 0 to 1 3x square dx. Let us see how to evaluate this. This is equal to integration 0 to 1 we can take 3 outside of the integration x square dx. It is equal to 3 into integration of x square is x cube upon 3 from 0 to 1. 3 and 3 will get cancelled. It is equal to 1 cube minus 0 cube. It is equal to 1. Hence, this second part, integration 0 to 1 fx dx, here it should be dx, is equal to 1. And therefore, the function fx is equal to 3x square for 0 to 1 is a proper probability density function. Also, for real numbers c and d, such that 0 is less than equal to c, is less than d, is less than equal to 1. Probability for x between c and d is integration from c to d fx dx, that is d cube minus c cube, after solving the integration. D cube minus c cube, it is certainly greater than 0, it is certainly less than 1. Next question is, what is probability that x falls between half and 1? That is, we want probability of x between half and 1. So put c is equal to half, d is equal to 1 over here, then we get probability of x between half and 1 is 1 cube minus half cube. It is equal to 7 by 8. What is probability x is equal to half? For any single point, you will get the probability equal to 0. Second one, let x is a continuous random variable whose probability density function is fx is equal to x cube upon 4 for an interval 0 to c. What is the value of constant c that makes fx a valid probability density function? Note that the integral of PDF over the support of random variable must be 1. That is, integration 0 to c fx dx is equal to 1. The integration of x cube is x raised to 4 upon 4. This previous 4 is there, so 1 by 16 times x raised to 4. It is equal to c raised to 4 minus 0 raised to 4 upon 16. So it is c raised to 4 upon 16. Since this integration is equal to 1, c raised to 4 is equal to 16, and therefore c is equal to 2, since we want c to be a positive. Third, let us return to the example in which x has the following probability density function, fx is equal to 3x square. What is the cumulative distribution function of fx? Fx is equal to, capital Fx is equal to, this negative sign should not be there because 0 is signless. So here it should be 0, 0 to x fx dx. It is x cube after solving this integration. I am skipping fourth problem as it is very easy. Let us see this example number 5. Suppose the PDF of continuous random variable x is defined as fx is equal to x plus 1 for minus 1 to 0 and fx is equal to 1 minus x for 0 to 1. Find cumulative distribution function capital Fx. If we look at the PDF, it is defined in two steps. First step for minus 1 to 0 and second step for 0 to 1. Now for the other two intervals, minus 1 to 0 and 0 to 1, capital Fx is equal to minus 1 to x, x plus 1 dx. That is, the integration of x is x square by 2, integration of 1 is x, from minus 1 to x. So putting x initially and then putting minus 1 in place of x, we get this result. After calculation, it is x plus 1 bracket square upon 2. F of 0 is equal to half. Capital F of 0 is equal to half. Now, for the second part, for 0 less than x less than 1, capital Fx is equal to probability 0 less than x less than 1, that is probability minus 1 to 0 plus probability 0 to 1. That is minus 1 to 0 x plus 1 dx and 0 to x 1 minus x dx. The first probability is half and the second probability is 0 to x 1 minus x dx. After calculating, integration of 1 is x and integration of minus x is x square by 2. Here it should be negative, I think. 1 minus x, is it the case? Yes, 1 minus x. So here it is 1 minus x. Its integration is x minus x square. Let us see by calculation. Integration 1 dx minus integration 0 to x dx. It is equal to x from 0 to x minus x from 0 to, sorry, x integration is x square by 2 from 0 to x. So this is x minus 0 minus half out x square minus 0 square. So it is x minus x square by 2. Here it should be x minus x square by 2. Make proper change in your book. Look here, in the next step it is minus x square by 2. And therefore capital Fx is equal to half x plus 1 bracket square from minus 1 to 0 and equal to half plus x minus x square by 2 for 0 to 1. The sixth problem is, verify the following functions are PDF of continuous random variable. First one, fx is equal to e raised to minus x for 0 to infinity and it is equal to 0 otherwise. That is, if x is below 0, then the value of function is 0. Fx is equal to x by 2 for minus 2 to 2 and equal to 0 otherwise. That means other than this minus 2 to 2, that is for x is equal to 5 or x is equal to 10 or x is equal to minus 100, the value of fx is 0. Now we want to find the whether this function is PDF or not. The first one, e raised to minus x is greater than or equal to 0 for any value of x, since you know that e is number like pi. Its approximate value is 2.71828, etc. It is actually limit of the function x tending to 0, 1 plus x raised to 1 upon x. This limiting value is equal to this number near to 2.71828. It is just a number like pi. And any positive number, say 2 point something, it's any power, positive or negative, always give you a positive number. Hence e raised to minus x is greater than 0 for 0 less than x less than infinity. So the first condition is satisfied. Let us see the second condition. Integration from 0 to infinity fx dx. it is equal to integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus x dx. It is the integration of e raised to minus x is minus e raised to minus x. Take minus outside and evaluate this. Once put value 0 and next value infinity. E raised to minus infinity, that is 1 upon e raised to infinity is 0. So this value is here negative remained. This value is 1, and hence both the conditions of PDF are satisfied, and therefore this fx is PDF of continuous random variable. Secondly, fx is equal to x by 2 from minus 2 to 2. Fx is negative for minus 2 to 0, and therefore fx is not PDF. So this is not PDF. First one was PDF. We have seen it. Let us see problem number 7. Find k if the following function is PDF of random variable x. Fx is equal to k times x square into 1 minus x for 0 less than x less than 1 and is equal to 0 otherwise. Since fx is a PDF of random variable x, integration from 0 to 1 fx dx is equal to 1. Now evaluate this integration and find out the value of k, and your answer is there. Next one, for each of the following PDF of random variable x, find probability x less than 1 and second probability mod x less than 1. First one, fx is equal to x square by 18 for minus 3 to 3 and is equal to 0 otherwise. Actually, this problem should be written like this. Fx is equal to x square by 18 for minus 3 less than x less than 3. It is equal to 0 otherwise. Some space is saved in this type of writing. But don't get confused, this type of function is there. Similarly, this fx is equal to x plus 2 upon 18 for minus 2 to 4, otherwise it is 0. The first one, probability x less than 1. The function value starts from minus 3 and therefore integration from minus 3 to 1. Fx dx, fx is x square by 18. Evaluating this integration, we have the value 14 upon 27. Just note that always this answer should be, answer of probability should be between 0 and 1. Between 0 and 1. Secondly, probability mod x less than 1. That means probability of x between minus 1 and plus 1. So it is integration minus 1 to plus 1 fx dx. After evaluation, the answer is 1 upon 27. Similarly, this second problem, you can check it yourself. Let us see the exercise 7.2. The first problem, verify which of the following is PDF of random variable x. The first one is fx is equal to sin x for 0 to pi by 2. 0 to pi by 2 means first quadrant. And for first quadrant, sin x is always positive. This thing you know very well. In first quadrant, sin x is positive. So the first condition, fx is greater equal to 0 for all x between 0 to pi by 2, the first condition is clear. The second condition, integration 0 to pi by 2 fx dx, that is integration 0 to pi by 2 sin x dx, it is equal to integration of sin x is minus cos x from 0 to pi by 2. It is equal to cos of pi by 2, firstly upper value, minus lower value cos of 0. It is equal to minus into bracket 0 minus 1. Cos pi by 2 value is 0 and cos 0 is 1. So this answer is 1. So the first condition is satisfied, second condition is also satisfied. Therefore the first one, fx is equal to sin x for 0 to pi by 2, is the probability distribution function of random variable capital X. The second problem is fx is equal to x for 0 less than equal to x less than equal to 1. I will write it here next part. It is equal to 2 minus x for 1 less than x less than 2. The function is from 0 to 2. From 0 to 2. We have to verify whether it is PDF or not. Firstly, let us see the positiveness. For 0 to 1, fx is x. So x is positive or greater or equal to 0 from 0 to 1. So first condition is satisfied. For the second condition, for the second part of the condition, from 1 to 2, the function is 2 minus x. So if you put any number between 1 to 2 over here, you will get 2 minus a number between 1 to 2. So this number is also greater equal to 0 for all values of x. And therefore the first condition, fx greater equal to 0 for all x between 0 and 1. 0 and 2 is satisfied. Let us now see the integration. Integration from 0 to 2 fx dx. It is equal to integration 0 to 1. 0 to 1, the integral fx is x dx, minus integration 1 to 2, function is 2 minus x dx. This is equal to the integration of first is x square by 2 from 0 to 1, minus integration of 2 is 2x from 1 to 2, minus integration of x is x square by 2 from 1 to 2. This is equal to half taken out inside the bracket, 1 square minus 0 square. 1 square minus 0 square, minus curly bracket, 2 taken out, 2 minus 1, minus half taken out into 2 square is 4. 2 square is 4, minus 1 square is 1. It is equal to half, minus 2 minus 1 is 1, 2 into 1 is 2, minus minus plus 3 by 2, minus this 4 minus 1 is 3, 3 by 2, this is 4 by 2, 4 by 2 minus 2 is 0. It is not equal to 1. Hence, not PDF. This third one, fx is equal to 2. If we take f of say 0.5, f of 0.5, it is equal to 2. It is not less than 1. And therefore, this function is not a PDF of random variable x. The next problem is, following is PDF of a random variable x. Fx is equal to x by 8 for 0 less than x less than 4. And it is equal to 0 otherwise. Find first probability x less than 1.5, probability 1 less than x less than 2, and third probability x greater than 2. The answer is very clear. We have given PDF, so no need to prove it is PDF or etc. Here directly what you can do is find the probability. Probability of x less than 1.5, it is equal to integration. The lowest value of x is 0 in this case. So from 0 to 1.5 fx dx, that is integration from 0 to 1.5 fx is x by 8 dx. Integration of this 8 is constant, it can be taken outside of the integration, and integration of x is x square upon 2. So it becomes 1 upon 8 into 1 upon 2 from x square from 0 to 1.5. It is equal to 1 by 16 into 1.5 square minus 0 square, that is 2.25 divided by 16. Equal to 0.1406. Second one is probability for 1 less than x less than 2. We can calculate it by integration. Probability 1 less than x less than 2. It is integration from 1 to 2 fx dx, that is x by 8 dx. It is equal to 1 by 16 x square from 1 to 2, which is equal to 2 square minus 1 square upon 16, equal to 3 upon 16. You can calculate it in decimal point. Third one, probability x greater than 2. I am going to leave it as homework for you. Probability x greater than 2 is equal to integration from 2 to the upper limit of x is 4. 2 to 4 fx dx. That is integration 2 to 4 x by 8 dx. The rest job is yours. Let us discuss the third problem. It is known that error in measurement of reaction temperature in degree Celsius in a certain experiment is continuous random variable given by fx is equal to x square upon 3 for minus 1 less than x less than 2 and it is equal to 0 otherwise. Verify whether fx is a PDF of a random variable. For any value of x between minus 1 and 2, x square is always greater or equal to 0 for any real number x. So this x square upon 3 always greater than or equal to 0. So the first condition being PDF is clear. Now second condition, integration from minus 1 to 2 check whether it is equal to 1. It has to be 1, and therefore it is equal to, it is the PDF, fx is the PDF of random variable. To find out probability 0 less than x less than 1, that means you want integration from 0 to 1 x square by 3 dx. Calculating this, you can find out. Just remember that you can take 3 outside of the integration, and integration of x square dx is x cube upon 3. Use this and solve. You will find the answer. Next one, find probability that x is negative. X is negative means minus 1 to 0. The probability of this is probability x is less than 0 equal to integration from minus 1 to 0 x square by 3 dx. Calculating this, you can find out the required answer. Let us solve the next problem. Only one I am going to solve. I think I should solve this first one, or should I solve second? Let us solve the second one. Both are similar. Let us copy this to our board. Copied. Let us solve this second one. Fx is equal to k into x into 1 minus x for 0 to 1. It is equal to 0 otherwise. We have to find out k if this is a PDF. Since fx is PDF, integration over the support, here the support is from 0 to 1. 0 to 1 fx dx is equal to 1, and therefore integration 0 to 1 fx is k x into 1 minus x dx is equal to 1, and therefore k is constant taken outside, multiplication of this bracket, x minus x square dx, integration from 0 to 1 is equal to 1, and therefore k, integration of x is x square by 2 minus x cube by 3 from 0 to 1 is equal to 1. Therefore, k into bracket 1 square by 2 minus 1 cube by 3 minus 0 square by 2 minus 0 cube by 3 is equal to 1. Therefore, k into half minus 1 by 3 is 3 minus 2 upon 3 into 2, that is 1 by 6 is equal to 1. And therefore, k is equal to 6. The first answer of finding k is over. Now we want probability of x between 1 by 4 and 1 by 2. Probability 1 by 4 is less than x is less than 1 by 2 is equal to integration from 1 by 4 to 1 by 2 fx dx. We have already found out the integration. It is k into x square by 2 minus x cube by 3. and the value of k is we have found out is 6. So I'm directly using that 6 into x square by 2 minus x cube by 3 from 1 by 4 to 1 by 2. This is equal to 6 into bracket. Firstly, put this value half square upon 2 minus half cube upon 3 minus 6 into 16 into 1 by 4 square minus 1 by 4 cube upon 2 and here upon 3. This is equal to 6 into 1 by 2 square is 1 by 4 into 1 by 2 is 1 by 8 minus 1 upon 24 minus 6 into 1 upon 32 minus 1 upon 64 into 3 equal to 6 by 8 into bracket 1 minus 1 by 3 minus 6 upon 32 into bracket 1 minus 1 by 6 equal to 6 upon 8 into 2 by 3 minus 6 upon 32 into 5 by 6. Here 6 cancel out. 3 2's are 6, 2 2's are 4. So it is half minus 5 upon 32. 16 2's are 32, so 16 minus 5, 11 upon 32 is the answer. And this probability x less than half, it is for homework, you can solve it easily. It is integration from 0 to half fx dx. Read this 10th problem. If a random variable x has PDF, fx is equal to c upon x for 1 less than x less than 3. C is greater than 0. Find c, expected value of x and variance of x. For a continuous random variable, we have not given in our book the formula or any theory about expected value of x and variance of x. We have given only for the discrete random variable. Certainly there is a formula for this, but as it is not given in your book, I am not taking it here. If anybody interested can call me personally, I will tell you how to evaluate this. Let us solve this 9th problem. Let us copy it to our board. Firstly, we write fx. Fx is equal to x square upon 3 for minus 1 less than x less than 2, and it is equal to 0 otherwise. Capital Fx, the cumulative distribution function, capital Fx is equal to the lowest value of x is minus 1, minus 1 to x fx dx equal to integration from minus 1 to x square upon 3 dx equal to 1 by 3 times इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर इज एक्स क्यूब अपॉन 3 फ्रॉम माइनस 1 टू एक्स, 1/3 आउट, 1/9 इंटू एक्स क्यूब माइनस माइनस 1 क्यूब. सो कैपिटल एफ एक्स इज एक्स क्यूब प्लस 1 अपॉन 9. नाउ फर्स्टली वी वॉन्ट प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ एक्स लेस देन 1. दैट मीन्स वी वॉन्ट एफ ऑफ 1. एफ ऑफ 1 इज 1 क्यूब प्लस 1 अपॉन 9. इट इज 2/9. सेकेंडली वी वॉन्ट प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ एक्स लेस देन माइनस 2. इट इज इक्वल टू, नाउ सिंस द मिनिमम वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम माइनस 1 एंड दिस कैपिटल एफ इट हैज द लिमिट्स फ्रॉम माइनस 1 टू 2 ओनली. सो फॉर एक्स लेस देन माइनस 2 द प्रोबेबिलिटी इज 0. डू नॉट पुट द वैल्यू इन दिस फंक्शन कैपिटल एफ एक्स. Thirdly, we want probability of x greater than 0. Let us think complementary. It is equal to 1 minus probability x less than 0. It is raining heavily outside, therefore the background disturbance is there. Let me finish this problem, then I will take a pause. Equal to 1 minus f of 0 equal to 1 minus 0 cube plus 1 upon 9. It is equal to 8 upon 9. And fourth one we want probability of 1 less than x less than 2. It is equal to f of 2 minus f of 1. It is equal to 2 cube plus 1 upon 9 minus 1 cube plus 1 upon 9. 8 minus 1, it is 7 upon 9. Thank you for today. Let us conclude this probability distribution lesson for science only over here. We will meet in the next session for binomial distribution, etc.